Welcome to another video on my hydraulic system made of Visitechnic Robo interface, a power motor not from Visitechnic but almost same manufacturer, different ratio, which means it runs slower, but it is stronger. With chain switches to signal the height of the hydraulic pistons. This one goes manual, and this one I want to automate. Last time I figured out that this chain is not going to work out. So I prepared this one, and yes, that one makes sure that it rolls slowly but surely, but that means that I have to change a few things in the setup. The chain will go and the motor will go vertical instead of horizontal. So this will be the connection to this worm, whatever you call it. So another major reconstruction, some wiring to be added, some programming to be added, and then hopefully it works out. So let's get started. All right, and then with a different view. This is of course the coda, the diagnostic interface, and obviously the hardware. First thing to do is remove the entire chain with gears and see how I can get this one running. So first of all, this one out, and also this one, since this one has some kind of open space in it, I can connect this one, or should be. Okay, so not that this is the solution because it's going vertical, but now I can test if this is strong enough, and it probably is. So let's see about this, holding my fingers here, and how will it run? Easiest to do. Oh wait, I forgot to open a terminal. And actually run the program, so I still have to go there, and now run it. And then it is, yeah, let's do it like this. Yeah, it lacks some necessary colons. Now it will work. No attribute set motor. All right, I am afraid I have to check that out. In the meantime, then let me use this one. Robo, yeah. And it's pushing it out. So the other way around. Now that is actually working. Yep. So that principle works. I can replace this one with a shorter one, which is, I think, a rather good idea. And then put everything vertical. So let's do that. Oh, and solve somehow this code, but this code has little use without the hardware being in place. So right now, the motor is positioned vertically with a new gear mounted with a very short axle connected to the piston. Switches as yet not mounted yet. So let's see how this works out. And yes, you notice that is that the camera is at the moment handheld. So that is not going according to plan. So it is pushing it down, but it is lifting the motor rather than pushing the piston down. So I think I have to fix this one and then see how I can make the motor stay at its place. Yeah. Plans don't always work out, unfortunately. So let's see how we can fix this. Alright, so I have fixed this vertical worm gear or worm axle down below. Also stabilized this construction. Question is, will it really help? I don't know yet. Something else I noticed is that these connections for the water on both sides rather easily let go. So I have spilled drops of water. Does that mean that I should refill? Probably, but I won't do that yet, since I'm still constructing. Anyway, let's see how this ends up. Oh, I see some positive movement. Okay, let's put the camera in place. So this is what I'm looking at. Change hand for the camera. And yes, this is kind of moving downwards. Now will it pull it up? Yes, it is definitely pulling it up. But as you can see, it is not entirely easy, but it is working. So yeah, in that way, my idea is now successful. So now I can start mounting the switches somehow. I also have to see that this is going straight, but so far so good. How do I mount these since everything has changed around it? Because I also have to keep in mind this.
How do I do that?
I better have them going around here. Because tubes, the way they are now, I don't like that. It's according to the example, but examples are mostly just what they are, examples. So yeah, let me reroute or try to reroute this tube to the inner part of, this is better to see, to the inner part of the pistons. Then I can freely place this. Right, with the new part of construction, I imagined that this part, which is connected to the piston and can easily touch one of the sensors, it can touch one of this, it can touch this sensor as well. And as you can see, input one is responding. So if this puts down, there's no problem acting on those sensors. I just have to wire it. And as you can see how I have put it onto this standard, quite, well, I wouldn't say easy, but it's a way. Is it stable? I do hope so. I haven't tested it yet. So let's do that and see how things work out. And this is a better lighting. By lack of better lighting. So let's see how this works out. Now by diagnostics again. Yes, and their input is on. So that works nicely. And then up again. And here is a little problem, because you can see that this part of the plate is lifted. I can easily move it. And that's a weak part of this design or this idea. So will this work out in a nicer way? I don't know yet. Let's once again try it. I hope this lighting will be. The camera is rather light sensitive. So you can see how it is affected. And now in the program it should stop by now, because this sensor is impressed, but it's not wired. Oops, this sensor is impressed now, not wired, so not acting. So I have to wire it and then program it. But the idea is now that despite this weak part, it works. Well, as you can see, the second sensor has been wired now, also viewable here with two switches to earth or ground, and here to the inputs. And you can also see here input 2 is activated with this clearly impressing. So everything is wired now, it should work. And the question is, does it work when programmed? So let's deactivate this for now and see if everything is done, because I am still not quite sure if right and left are indeed what they should be. Oh right, and then I have the problem that said motor has a problem, or shows a problem. This
should work anyway. I copied this from other programs which do work. Let me comment this out because I'm not writing any data yet. But set motor should work. So let's go here and set motor shows a problem. I'll have to tackle it. Alright, I have had to change just a small S into a capital S, and it works. So let's start. Hopefully it works out. The point is now that print doesn't work, so how to figure out if it really does work? I will see you soon enough, I hope. Or does it? It has no... Oh, you're right, then this will have to be capital D and capital D. Go. That motor number. That's a new one. How can it have a bad motor number? It is one motor. Surprise, surprise. Anyway, I'll leave that for next time. This should be working. This is working, that is proven. So let's do it like this for now. Right, and up. And that's it. So diagnostics shows it does work. Well, this not quite as yet. I can shift this up, of course. So it will have to do for now.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. With this kind of working stuff. If please leave comment or suggestion, very much appreciated. You can also follow me via Instagram and Twitter. Please show your support by making a donation via either PayPal or Wired. You can also become a patron and may have your name mentioned depending on the pledge you make. Your name will be mentioned on my website and with my videos. Please visit also my website, which is mentioned under this video, but also in the next segment, to see more of my projects. This is going to be continued, of course. For now, have a nice day and bye-bye.